Oh my god, I don't think I'm gonna fix it anytime now. It looks like a ghost. I guess that's why they gave us these tablets, because they seem to be defective. I just, well, first of all, it's Tuesday. I'm going to say it's Tuesday, March 29th, 2022. I'm on my way, you know, well, it's at 5 p.m. Right now, it's only 8 minutes after 1 p.m. It's only 8 minutes after 1 p.m. in the afternoon. My appointment is at 5, so I have plenty of time. I like to, you know, take it easy. That's why I don't take morning appointments. It's like, yeah, I gotta be in, like, in the mood, I guess. I don't know, but I don't feel like. Oh, and besides, I have my third, it's my third or fourth call. You know, like pre-surgery telephone call. You know, it's like very helpful, very helpful. I must say, this guy, he knows his shit. You know, he was telling me, you know, what kind of bruises are not good, you know, especially what kind of color, you know, especially a certain area. You know, he was explaining to me, you know, why, you know, the whole purpose of the dilation after surgery, you know, and one of the purposes is to condition the scar tissue to grow a certain way in a certain place, you know. It's like, you know, it's like a mess. Something like, oh yeah, it's just crazy, you know. So yeah, it's a whole thing. It's a whole process. So I might not be up for the summer. But I'm gonna start saving my money so I can go to Florida or something. There's no freaking way I can stay these winters over here. And mind you, it's very convenient this winter. We had a whole like 3-4 days in the upper 50s and 60s. Even we had some days that it was in the 80s. I mean, those were gifts, and I'm really grateful. I'm really grateful to have those. You know what I mean? So, when it's cold, it's cold. It's no BS. Cold, it's cold. Like today, it's freezing. It's freezing. I'm like, why didn't I take my gloves? Oh my God, no, don't start again. Especially when the little air come out. When that tiny little air come out, it's just like, I'm like, please stop, please stop. It just go like, I got two coats and a pashmina, which I mean, that's what I'm probably gonna have to do in a little while, just wrap it around my neck at least. Worst come to worst, I have to cover my ears with that, you know. Freezing. Anyway, the reason I wanted to live stream, because I wanted to jot things down. I'm not good at writing, you know, fast and legible and stuff. So for me, like, this is a great option to put down my thoughts and, you know, what's coming up to the mind. So last night started listening to, he got a doctor's degree, but it's not in medicine, you know, which, I mean, like, right now, he's going to Harvard Med School for, oh my God, because I think all his family died from cancer or something, or heart attack, you know, it's like, you know, the supremacy, you know, so that's why he was, you know, I found him, you know, doing like searches in social media in 2019, you know, like late December 2019. And I thought, it's like, well, you know, he's saying shit that, you know, that I have already heard, you know, doing the searches, you know, about it, how unusual, you know, SARS, you know, was, because it had 3 segments of a retroviral. So it's a mixture of, you know, like, say HIV and stuff, you know, like, I don't know. I mean, I don't know if we're supposed to say, still allowed to say that. This is like, McCarthyism is back. So, I got sleepy, because it was a long live stream. Sometimes he has short live streams and, you know, he erased them immediately. Don't erase them, but put them on private. I think he erased them, yeah, because I think it said, don't exist. Yeah, I think he erased them, you know, because I think the live streams are not really live. It's kind of like, I mean, you can do a live stream of a recording, you know, that's how they weird again. Let me put some of the little phones for. So, these things are falling off. You're falling down, falling off. My leggings. Oh, yeah, the elastic band is like at the beginning, is really. I guess I had to buy large, because if I buy extra large, that means like triple X or something, I don't know. So anyway, so, you know, I woke up and whatever, you know, I was looking, you know, at my gadgets. You know, I just had a new iPod replacement, another one, because shit was freezing all the time. It's like really, really bad quality, you know, for the iPod. It's an MP3, you know, iPod Touch. I mean, it worked with the Wi-Fi if you want to use, you know, the apps and stuff. Got all the apps, obviously. Oh my god. Why, where's this shit come from? I think I overslept. Yesterday I slept a lot. I was hibernating. And I still have stuff to do before, you know, my surgery. And before the summertime. Just give me the crumbs, yeah. Oh yeah, I gotta leave it over there because that speaker don't hold the signal very well. So I woke up and I saw that I still can hear it. You know, I'm like, I'm watching. You know, but you know, there's nothing to see. You know, that pale thing, kind of like, even like what I look like now. They look like that all the time, you know. So, but I was listening and I thought it was like, you know, I don't know, I guess I was sleepy, whatever, you know. I don't remember, but. And I said, like, oh shit, this thing's not erased. I don't know, I guess, you know, this is how they get us. This is how they get us, you know, just start thinking like, you know, okay, so the algorithm is not too harsh today. You wake up and try to see, you know, how harsh is the algorithm? It's like the algorithm is like programmed to even say good morning and already like, cut off the live stream. And some days the algorithm ain't that bad. So I was listening, I was remembering, and I was like, you know, I put it on my channel. It's not ready yet, it's still editing. I want to leave it off, you know, right where the juicy stuff. Because people, they don't see like, oh. I mean, if you know me, then you know. This bitch is posting cracker shit on. It gotta be because of something. I don't post nothing, you know? I'm gonna say his name, yeah. His name is Paul Cottrell. C-O-T-T, with C-O-T-T-E-R-R-E-L. They call himself Dr. Paul Cottrell because, you know, he got a doctor but not medicine. And that is frustrating because, you know, it takes another, cracker to find out another cracker, you know. You gotta interpret, you gotta translate, you know, all the BS. I mean, I couldn't believe it that, you know, after he'd been like so careful, now he left that video up there. I was like, really? He always deleted him. I mean, he actually said that it was necessary. You know, Hiroshima and Nagasaki was necessary to find out, you know, how the world would react. Like, and then he tried to say that, oh, we wouldn't know the real effects of radiation, you know, if it wasn't because of. I mean, just like that. I mean, it's the same shit I've always been saying, you know? The same quackery, crackery. From always, and I one of the things that I got him, because it, like, I never really hear them talk about, he called it the theater. They call it theater, you know, but, you know, the propaganda machine that is wholly weird, you know. He was crying about that. Oh my God, you know, we're gonna lose. I gotta watch it again, see what the words he used. He used all these words, you know. I think they're picked to make sure nobody arrives, you know. Nothing arrives in the people, you know. But sorry, I'm losing my train of thought. It's just it's too damn cold. My hands are frozen. I mean, it was so nice and sunny when I left the house. These ratchet bitches from hell. We gotta straight stare somebody in the eye for. So, here's some. I mean, if some people watch it, this is somebody who the whole lockdown. I'm telling you, I know him. I mean, I don't watch all the live streams. Obviously, but I watch a lot of, because I looked them up too. that's when you really get to know somebody. When they go to another channel and they start like, they let themselves loose. Because it's not their damn channel, right? And yes, we have had African American guest in his show. I mean, like, and this is Mohat. This is Mohat. I mean, like, this is what we're talking about. That people say, like, oh, it's so damn offensive because these Mohat cannot be loving swastikas. Really? Really? Flying. I'm just gonna do this. I think I should just put it on like this. You know, it's too freezing. Yeah, I'm gonna just leave it like this here. If they decide to show up. If they decide to show up today, then there they have it. Oh my god. Hands are frozen. I gotta put them there. That woman, she just stared at me like, you know, like, for real, all the way from there, and I kept like looking at you like saying, what are you looking at, you know, and she heard me. I mean, like, this is why I don't jump as hard as I used to, you know. Say, you know, a bitch this, a bitch that, a bitch this, a bitch that, you know, like, well, they have turned us into these really reckless beings, because a lot of them women believe that, you know, that just saying, you know, all these words, you know, patriarchal, bully, you know, all this stuff, you know, give us a pass. That should give us a pass to do whatever we want. And it's not true. And it's not true in my life. I mean, a bitch is gonna get drafted. I want them all to get drafted. All these gender equality bitches, like, I want them all, take them all away. The children are better off without those things, for real. Anyway, going back to Dr. Paul Cottrell. That's how I remember his name. You know, that was the whore, well, that was redundant, right? From Saved by the Bell. It's still recording. Oh my god, I pressed something. I knew this was gonna happen. Damn, people don't believe me. This is horrible. I don't wanna be here no more. I don't know what I was gonna do. I was doing, you know, that. Moving all the way here. You know, like Neanderthal capital. I mean, I don't know. I guess it's one of the capitals of the Neanderthals. I don't know. So damn cold. It's too damn cold. There's a freaking wind. Come on. Come on. I mean, this is the last day of March. You did not do that the whole thing. I know March is known for the wild winds. Where's the 29? Come on. Anyway, no, the evenings are wild. The evenings are wild. Even my cats, they go like, they go the window. They love the window, like, because they see all that shit happening out there. And they're like puzzled, like, look at all that shit going there. Oh, there's a bag. They don't know it's a bag. I don't know what they think. It was so good because I put it on my boot. I put my boot over there. Otherwise, it would have broken if it had fallen. And then it went all the way to the mulch over there. It's like it fell in the mulch. I was like, oh my god, I gotta hold on to this shit now. Maybe I should put it like this. I don't know. I don't see any. I mean, I see like a ghost. I did the resets. I resetted the settings already, and this shit happened. Unbelievable. Anyway, where was I? Yeah, of course, you know, like, but he was like, he was telling all the symptoms of, you know, Hiroshima. Let me pause this. Well, that's one of the good things of not being live streaming, you know. You can pause it, people don't have to. No, I tried to go away. I know I hate some people that they like do all kinds of shit on video. Especially if you're eating, like if you're watching somebody. Anyway, oh my gosh, where was I? I'm like, before I turn it on, I should. So it was good because of that, you know, he went through the stages, which is kind of like how I'm going to be putting it up, you know. I think that's how I'm going to be putting it. I'm going to make it several copies and I'm going to put different segments, you know. So, because yes, he like so naturally admitted like, yes, we are going to be losing, you know, the propaganda machine in the East. Because, I mean, already India came through and said that, you know, hey, you know, Bollywood and Nollywood, I guess Nollywood, right, too, that they can collaborate, they can use their studios and whatever, and like, so, this is huge, this is like, damn, this is decolonization, you know, happening, you know, that's some of the good things, you know. I mean, even in the whole mist of, you know, that I don't know if I'm gonna make it to May 3rd, right? You know, like, because that's the day of my surgery. And it just seemed like, you know, these devils, you know, just trying to, you know, like, you know, just literally you can see them poking President Putin's testicles every day, like, you know, see, let's see how much patience he got. Let's see, you know, if he really is, you know, sage, you know. The gentleman is about to turn. And I say gentleman because he's a gentleman. I mean, I have been watching him for a while. And I know, you know, Venezuela, Nicaragua, they have a lot more, you know. So, I mean, there's really nothing. There's really nothing. I mean, China got tons of skeletons, you know. They got much infrastructure in Ecuador. I mean, that's what I heard, you know. Like, there's some countries that in some projects, just like everything, you know. They can produce, you know, 20, I quote unquote. I heard something and I don't see nothing. I heard a thing like this, but nothing in the bank. So they can produce, you know, a $30,000 handbag, you know, I mean, if there's such thing, I mean, like, and they produce your $10 handy handbag. Right, I get on 149th Street, right, in the Bronx, and you know, so they when they're bad, you know. Ecuador is like, you know, because they cannot even get any loans, which is kind of like a good thing probably, because I don't know, they say without credit you're nothing. I don't know, not me, I don't want credit because, you know, to pay back, I mean, like, it's hell. Unless it's like a government, you know, that they have, like in Mexico. That's why I want to go back so bad. I want to go back. And, I mean, I don't know. But, you know, once I'm free, you know, once I finish my last surgery, I'm like, I mean, I'm halfway through, you know, like, which is like, you know, like an 8-hour surgery. It should be more like a 4-hour surgery, 5-hour surgery for me. I don't know, four. I don't know. I don't know how long they're going to stay. Hopefully it's not going to be a long surgery. Like, you know, like 8-10 hours sometimes. You know, it's like, so, because I'm, you know, I'm halfway through, I'm hoping I'm not going to have, you know. Yeah, and the surgery doula said that, you know, that, you know, don't expect, you know, the whole 8 hours. You know, hopefully in half, they cut it off, the time in half, and the healing in half and everything, you know, just, the first half that was like, the recovery time, just because you get like so many nerves, you know, like up to my belly, some shit like that. I had like, oh my God, I remember that shit. The surgery was a breeze. It was a 40 minute surgery. I woke up like an hour late. I mean, you know, right after I went to, probably, I think I woke up, I started walking, like whatever, but sore. You know, it was like really painful in your belly or the pelvic area. It's just like it's somebody just grabbed me with a baseball bat, you know. Now I got a tickling nose, tickling throat. That shit happened out of nowhere. I mean, it's so strong. And it's bougie. And it's bougie coffee. You can get it for $17, the biggest bag, Costco, $17, I'm sure it's still GMO and shit, but anyway, it tastes good, that's why I do like very little sips, because I made it strong. I'm like, I gotta drink a lot of water. I have my water right now, I'm gonna drink it all up. There they are, my friends. I might have to do more crumbs for them. Let's finish that. Oh my God, I'm all over the place, right? I'm all over the place. This is like, you know. No, but, yeah, I'm happy that I got him on video. Because I'm hoping to not going to be making always, so the rest of my life, I'm going to be making a lot of videos from that video. And reproductions, I'm going to be like, they recognize, like, because they're always like, oh no, we just make, you know, movies and television series and whatever, and like, you know, of course, you know, who else? Of course, we always paint ourselves, you know, as superheroes, super humans, which exactly, they're not even humans, they're mankind, because they're kind of a man. So, yeah, I mean, he said it's like, yeah, but we can, you, oh, he had the nerve, you know, because that's how delusional they are, you know, to say that we can go into the oceans, because the oceans are unexplored, whatever, like, and what are you going to find? We're pouring about, you know, hundreds of, you know, tons of garbage a day in the bottom of the oceans. That's why you don't see as much as we used to see, all the landfills, all that shit. Now everything out of sight, I'm like, whatever, you know, by the time they're counting, or by the time people, you know, we get the technology to go at the bottom of the ocean, by the time you know, it's gonna be you know, they're gonna be dead, as always, right? They're like, and of course nobody's talking about, you know, how we've been robbed, we've been wiped out, you know, more than $30 trillion in less than 20 years, national debt, United Slaves foreign debt is $30 trillion plus, and they still, oh, actually, they introduced last week a bill, you know, which is the most largest amount they ever asked for weaponry already. They sell, they send billions to Ukraine. I mean, it's infuriating, even, you know, for people, you know, who are not in the United States, because Mexico, we have asked them for, we asked them for, I think, I don't know, we asked, you know, for a good amount, you know, to stop the migration, you know, to rebuild, because we got to rebuild Central America, because, you know, they have been given, the so-called cartels, they have been given so much weaponry and so much power that it need to be rebuilt. I mean, I don't know, in Salvador, they seem like, in El Salvador, let's say Salvador, whatever. It seemed like Bukele made a deal, conveniently. He made a pact. And I don't know what pact is about, but supposedly the violence have gone down a little bit in El Salvador. Supposedly, allegedly. That's what I hear from coming up. Let me do this one just a little bit too. So, anyway, yeah, that was something. That is something. Oh my God, they're flying on me. I wanted to fly, but not on me. I have to go on the floor. What else is there? I mean, yes, we're gonna go to the oceans. And we're gonna, like, you know, that's gonna be our, you know, strength. That's gonna be like whatever. It's like, we're still down in, oh hell no, we gotta get back China. They cannot get, you know, what is it, Taiwan? Oh, Shanghai, how many, I don't know how much land we have taken from, well, you know, whether it was Britain or whatever. And now it's just like, now you hear them, we're invested, like, you know, Ukraine have the right to be free and sovereign and whatever, the autonomy of Ukraine. What about Mexico? We don't get the right. We don't get the right. They just want us to become their, to continue becoming their backyard. I mean, it's just, it don't even make any sense. It don't even make any sense. And I wanted to, you know, to have been there and to leave a comment and say, bitch, you know, all the people that you have fucked up, all the people in those countries, including mine, we're starting to do moves for us to get reparations, to get our land back, to get, you know, indemnifications for all the shit that they have done, you know. I mean, like Honduras, you know, just the history of Honduras, you know, just like, you know, they were, you know, with slavery, it was like, until, if it wasn't because of President Daniel Ortega, there would still be slavery. You know, straight up slavery in Nicaragua. So everybody, you know, like the Arabs, they have a beef. They're like, that's why they didn't even pick up the damn phone. They didn't even pick up the damn phone for Biden. Oh, and another one that, you see, all these years, and I'm getting confirmation. Of all the shit that I've been saying. Guess what? This, whatever, senator, whatever, it was just right before I was leaving, you know, where I was leaving. Oh my God. I was getting out of the house. I saw this article on, it was the senator, whatever, and I say, like, the reason that the whole United Slaves is a mess and it's going down, like, in the drain, at the speed of light, is because of Biden. And let me give you the reason. I hope you're sitting down if you ever find this video. He said because he's Irish. because he's Irish. It's like all that shit's like, we all be insane. We all be insane. This is about, you know, any excuse to not share, you know, the control, to share power, to share nothing. I mean, they've been having like slaps, and like people, I see everybody lying about like, oh, you know, they don't want the Russians, like they don't want them because they're slaps, you know, they got the Tartar. They got Tartar blood and they got Asian blood. So they don't want him because of that. That's why they didn't want Stalin. They didn't want, you know, even I think Putin, that's why they don't want him. I think that he's also, yeah, he's obviously Slavic, you know. You know, they don't want him because, you know, if you see, he got the cheekbones and, you know, he got Tartar, but, you know, oh, he's like always passing for white and stuff, you know. They all do, you know. You know, I mean, until, you know, time will reveal true people's DNA, because they all think like, oh my God, we're so happy, we all got white skin now. Yeah, but the original dominant DNA, it's gonna come back sooner or later. Much, much sooner than later, you know, it's gonna start, and it's popping up. There's every family, you know, like in my family, you know, well, just my baby sister, she came out, you know, with original skin and booty. My sister, my older sister, and I just got the boobs. Yeah, my sister, I remember, like, she was like 13, 12, whatever. She, like, overnight, she went to double D's. Like, and my father's like, started fighting with her. She's like, am I dying? Call me a whore. Like, a 12-year-old girl. It's like, and my father was like, she looked like very grown up. She looked like very grown up overnight. And then, you know, somehow, I guess she was so stressed out because of that. I don't know. Her thyroid became acting out. And she got to be put on medication for thyroid, like my mom. And my grandfather had thyroid. He skipped me, thank God, knock on wood. Yeah. Oh my God. And Marcus is getting serious. I don't know what he wants. He came the other day and I'm like, he started like, I don't know. I know people got awakenings, but not that fast. I think myself, you know, I don't know. I don't know. Yeah, it's been such a week, you know, such a week. My friend in Oaxaca, she says she didn't get the house. She was supposed to get the inheritance from her father. She didn't get it, so, oh my God, I'm like, God, please, get me out of here, please, God, I'm staying in this freezing weather. I got everything here, but, you know, we have like 100 nuclear plants just east of Mississippi, and you see all these lunatics trying to burn them down in Europe. You know, just trying to start fires, like, just crazy, you know, like, oh, and I think they just closed, or they closed already, yeah, I think they closed, I don't know, they're about to close, I don't know, in Germany, because they joined the Clean Energy Pact, so they had to shut down half of their nuclear power plants, and it cannot be reversed. And I say, this is one of the greatest achievements of feminism. That idiot, she got trapped into shutting down half of their nuclear power plants. So, they need clean energy, but they're gonna be freezing to death. They don't want to pay in rubles, in rubles. They don't want to pay in rubles, rubles. I don't know how you say that, rubles, rubles, and rublos. They don't want to pay in rubles. So they don't want to pay, there's no, what they think is going to be Little Sisters of Mercy from the Federation. Hell no. You know, they deserve that. They deserve that. And I was not the only one, you know, because I mean, I knew. I was surprised. Turning your back on the Federation, for real? For real? For what? For what? You know, when you have the entire Emirates and you have India, Pakistan, they're like, you know, they are not going with the United Slaves narrative. They're not. They're like, get the F out of here. They're not doing it. Anyway, let me get out of here and start heading out. So I'm frozen. You know, I didn't think it was gonna be this crazy. I thought the wind, because I live in Washington Heights over there, it's always windy. I thought the wind was gonna slow down over here, but I'm probably just gonna walk to the clinic, like with two neighbors in my head. Maybe I understood anything I said to you in this video anyway. Later.